we are going to see about cockroach. We are very familiar with cockroach, as we see cockroach maybe in black or brown color, but there are different breeds, so cockroach appear in different colors. And their mode of nutrition is omnivorous. They can eat both plants and animals. Animals in the sense they can eat small insects. We can see most of the cockroaches live in wet areas. For example, we'll see cockroaches living in our kitchen. So that is their habitat. They live in damp places. And cockroach consume any organic matter like hair or insects or decayed materials. And their size ranges from 0.6 cm to 8 cm in length. This is their scientific classification. And you can see in this image, cockroaches are included under the phylum Arthropoda. So from the term itself, we can see arthro means joints. So their limbs are made up of many joints. And the characteristics of arthropods are they are bilaterally symmetrical. For example, if you divide this cockroach into two halves, they will be similar in their both sides. And then they are also composed of three layers of cells and they are called diploblasts. They contain cells like ecto, endo and meso. Now we will see the morphology of cockroach. So what is mean by morphology? The morphology means what we can see as a physical appearance. Their wings, their legs. So now we will see the morphology of cockroach. So in this image you can see the cockroach, and the cockroach body is divided into three parts. One is head, and the next one is thorax, and the last one is abdomen. Here the cockroach body is so segmented. Sometimes these segments become hard plates like structure, and these are called sclerites. If the sclerites present on the dorsal surface means they are called tergites, and if it presents on the ventral surface means they are called sternites. And these sclerites are joined by a membrane called arthrodial membrane, and these membrane will be thin and flexible, so thereby their movement can be easily done and the thorax will be stiff. Now we will see the dorsal view of cockroach. What is meant by dorsal and ventral view? The dorsal means the back side of the cockroach, and the ventral side means their inside, which faces the ground. So in dorsal surface you can see wings, and there are two wings. One is the forewing and the other one is hind wing. Actually you can see only the forewing because it covers the hind wing. So its function is protective. So forewing acts as protective for hind wing, and hind wing actually helps in flying. So mostly the forewing will be open, so we can't see the hind wing through our eyes, but if the cockroach flies means we can see the hind wing. And the hind wing is very large when compared to forewing, so thereby it can help in flying. Now we will see the ventral view of cockroach. As I already told you, ventral view we can see their limbs. Limbs are also called as appendages. In cockroach there are three limbs. One is forelimb and midlimb and hind limb. If you take forelimb and midlimb, moreover they will look similar. But hind limb will be larger when compared to forelimb and midlimb. In hind limb, there are some modifications happen in order to carry out jumping and hopping activities. Based on the location of forelimb, midlimb and hind limb, they are termed as prothoracic, mesothoracic and hind thoracic. As I already told you, cockroach is divided into head, thorax and abdomen. Now we will see the head. As you have seen, head of the cockroach will be in triangular shape, and consider this as its body. Okay? If you draw a line like this, the head will be in right angle to the longitudinal axis of the cockroach's body. And this head is made up of fusion of six segments. And the head of the cockroach also contains two antennas. So the function of this antenna is to communicate with the other insects. And during reproduction, with the help of this antenna, they will detect their mates. And the head also contains two compound eyes, and these eyes consist of specialized units called omatidia. Okay, they help in photoreceptor properties. Now we are seeing only the morphological characteristics. Many of the eye structures will be inside the eye. So the only thing visible is cornea. Now we will see the mouth part. So in this image you can see the various parts of mouth. Cockroach mouth consists of labrum and labium. Labrum means upper lip that consists of chemoreceptors which can sense chemicals in the food, thereby they can consume organic foods. And then the labium is the lower lip that consists of taste receptors, so they can sense taste. Then they consist of two pairs of maxilla and mandible. In mandibles they contain a thick appendages and a pointed tooth, and in maxilla they contain pointed tooth that helps in chewing and grinding, and they also contain smell senses. The next one is hypopharynx. They contain taste receptors, and the appearance of hypopharynx also looks like a tongue. So it acts as a tongue in cockroach. Now we will go to next part, that is thorax. In cockroach, thorax is divided into prothorax, mesothorax and metathorax. In thoracic region, the muscular structures will be more in order to carry out locomotion, because the wings and limbs are all coming into the thoracic cavity. So this cavity contains more musculatures. Now we will see abdomen. Abdomen is the largest part in cockroach. Nearly 10 segments come in abdomen. At the end of the 10th segment, there will be two filamentous structures called anal sulci. So consider this as the lowest part of the abdomen. So at the lowest part, each segment. So this part is the abdominal segment. So at the end of 10th segment, there will be two filamentous structures called anal sulci.
Thank you for watching. Visit us at needbook.in.